My name is Bernd Stemp, and I'm have the honor today to give you insight about our solution called Bring Your Own Key, Hold Your Own Key from Microsoft Azure Key Vault. And today I have also a colleague of mine with me. Maybe Johan, you can introduce yourself as well.
Yeah, sure, I can do. I can also do it later on when I have also something to show. But I'm Johan van der Belle, based in the Netherlands, and I'm the territory sales manager for the Benelux. And it's not just me, there are a few other people. So we are here with a whole team supporting the Belgium-Luxembourg region out of the Netherlands. And also locally, of course, via Arrow, whom we consider as our local representative. Okay, over to you again, Bernd.
Thank you very much. So yeah, basically, as I just explained, I'm in pre-sales, and I'm here at NSIF to support our customers and partners across the EMEA region. And NSIF is pretty long in the market, so we are not a startup. We are here since more than 20 years, offering crypto, dedicated crypto hardware to our customers for several use cases, which is cloud, IoT, blockchain, payments. And you might see our products in various customer sites and solutions. And since June last year, we belong to the Entrust Data Card Group, but run as a separate business on serving our customers. So let's continue. As I mentioned before, we're talking today about Microsoft Azure Key Vault and our solutions for that. And well, the relationship with Microsoft is pretty substantial, I would say, pretty old. So this is not a new partnership. So basically, Microsoft is one of our biggest technology partners as well as one of our biggest clients, and we're quite happy that we are serving the Azure Key Vault HSM hardware to Microsoft, allowing customers to securely manage their keys in a trusted environment within Azure Key Vault. And when we talk about crypto and crypto strategies, I think we are in Central Europe. Or in Europe at all, we're in a quite good position. Netherlands, for instance, is leading when it comes to encryption strategies. This is some information we get out of our annual global encryption trend study. We're running this study every year together with our clients to get an overview about crypto in general. And one output is for sure that we and the Netherlands and Central European countries are very well equipped when it comes to have a good strategy about crypto in general. So before we actually start with the Azure Key Vault, we just have a short reminder about general purpose HSMs in general. And therefore, I just want to give you a short reminder, look at HSMs in general. And HSM stands for Hardware Security Module, and basically it's a piece of hardware which is a tamper-resistant device equipped with a lot of crypto processing power, allowing you to manage and protect your keys and sensitive data in a trusted, secure environment. And basically the basic features for hardware security modules is generate keys and offer secure encryption environment, and of course interface with your application, and that's the basic functionality of a hardware security module. Well, first things first, and as I mentioned before in the last slide, there are some basic features of HSMs, which is security and performance. And what is the big differentiator between us and other HSMs on the market is the fact that we offer a unique ease of use for day-to-day tasks like backup, scalability, and resilience. So this is the main differentiator between our HSMs and others on the market. And our portfolio is basically well-stuffed. We have different kind of form factors for USB devices, PCI, and the most common one are network-attached HSMs. And there are different kind of use cases, like creating POCs, for instance, or equipping POCs, proof of concepts with HSMs, for instance, with a USB device, or when we operate in data centers, the most common version is the network-attached version. Well, let's have a look now about cloud and the challenges with cloud. And of course, there are some pros and cons. And let's start with the pros of using cloud services. And one of the most important one is, yeah, you pay only what you use. And that's basically comes along with the fact that you can easily scale up and downwards as required as your business grows or reduce. And of course, then connected to that is the capital investment, which is little or almost no. Of course, the cons about cloud adoption and cloud usage is that you somehow don't really own your data anymore. And you have to have a kind of trust relationship between your cloud provider somehow. Doesn't matter which cloud provider we are talking about. And there's an open module, the shared responsibility module, which illustrates the different kind of cloud types. As you probably know, there's infrastructure, platform, and software as a service. And here's compared also the responsibility, who actually needs to take responsibility. So when we have a look at the infrastructure, most of the responsibilities are owned by the customer. And this goes down as we approach platform and software as a service. But ultimately, basically, you are, as the owner of your data, you are responsible for the security. No matter where you host, at which cloud provider you host your applications, and no matter what kind of as a service you're going to choose, platform, software, or infrastructure, you are responsible for the data security. That's basically the output. And I try to give you a use case for German car manufacturer, which is called OEM. And basically, this German car manufacturer, they wanted to participate and make a use out of Microsoft's key management service. So they want to use Azure Key Vault in order to manage their keys within their cloud service provider. And they came up with the idea of BOIK, so bring your own key. That means you as a customer, you generate a key and then you securely manage these keys within your cloud provider. And we worked together with Microsoft since several years, as I illustrated before. And basically, Ncipher developed a solution allowing to securely manage keys within the Microsoft Azure Key Vault. And the basic idea is that the customer can bring the key, but Microsoft does not see or cannot extract the key. So they are just offering service to their customers, allowing to Microsoft to provide the availability of the keys, but they, as I mentioned before, cannot see or cannot extract and cannot use the key material. And that was quite important fact here for the overall strategy. So when we talk about BYK, as the name says, it's bring your own key. So The cloud provider needs to access or needs to get hold of the keys, but the important thing, they don't have direct access. Yeah? So they cannot use basically the key material. They are just there to provide availability of key material. And more important, as you are still the owner of the crypto material as a customer, you can do a kind of crypto shredding, which basically means as soon as you revoke the key within the cloud service provider, all the data will be inaccessible and unusable because you remove basically the crypto material, and all the data which has been encrypted by the initial key will be immediately inaccessible, no matter where they are stored. So if they have been synced to a different site, or if they are running in a different country, this does not affect the security, because as soon as you remove the key, all the actual data are inaccessible. And I've tried to illustrate the process of this this bring your own key procedure, and it's quite easy. It's set up in six different steps. So the first one is you download a so-called KEC, which is key encryption key for the particular region of Microsoft Azure Key Vault you want to operate the keys. And then you verify the key package is consistent and has not been altered during transition or during the transfer. And then basically the magic happens. You have your on-premise HSM, could be a USB HSM, but could be any other N-Cypher HSM. And at step four, a very important task happen. You reduce the ACL, the access control list, to the particular key, which means that you remove some attributes from the key. So that's meaning that you can export and or wrap a so-called private key. So this will eliminate the capability to export a key out of a hardware security module. And that's quite an important task here. And at step four, you add an additional attribute to a particular key, which is the Microsoft Azure Tenant ID. This gives you then two basically functions. First of all, you cannot extract the key of a HSM anymore. That's quite an important task. And secondly, you can only use the key in the context of your Azure Tenant ID. So that means that only you out of your Tenant ID process can actually use this particular key. That's quite important. And then step five, you basically encrypt your RSA private key, for instance, with the previously downloaded key encryption key, and then you securely upload the key to the Microsoft Azure Key Vault HSM. So this end up then with the fact that you basically run your private key within an HSM hosted in a dedicated Azure zone. The keys can't be extracted of this let's say cloud HSMs anymore, because you removed this particular feature from the key, and the key can only be used in the context of your tenant ID within the Azure Key Vault. So you receive basically and you retrieve basically two fundamental features. First of all, only you can use the encryption key and the data which has been encrypted with your key. And as soon as you remove the key out of your Key Vault HSM, Microsoft cannot reconstruct the key anymore, because they are only operate the key in the HSMs. And you only have the secure copy on side of your particular key, only you can reconstruct a key again to a cloud HSM. And this is the bring your own key approach. There's another one which is a kind of in between, which is the abbreviation hold your own key, or HYOK. This actually means that you operate the HSM on-premise while using cloud services from Microsoft, for instance. And last but not least, Microsoft can manage the keys. So this will then be a software or keys and software approach, which some customers can't do due to some legal or certification requirements. So as a summary, there's a described definition and introduction and overview about this bring your own key approach at Microsoft with the link here in the TechNet article of Microsoft. You can get this information and read through it. As I mentioned, it's very well described. But as a summary, the benefits of bring your own key are quite obvious. So keyboard protects your data with strong encryption. You create a key and you bring the key and you own the key, although you operate a key in the cloud. So you retain custodial and visibility of your keys, and Microsoft can only make the key available to you, but cannot misuse the key material. And last but not least, you use a trusted and certified platform, a hardware, a local hardware, in order to initially create a key and securely transfer it to your cloud service provider. Well, nCipher is offering a lot of services, a lot of cloud services, as I mentioned, with Microsoft together. But we have a very broad and wide technology partner program, which means that we work with various kind of security providers in the field, in the market, offering additional benefits, additional services to their own security platforms. And as you can see, we have a huge environment and ecosystem of various security providers in the PKI segment, for instance, key management segment, cloud database encryption segment. And our philosophy is to provide open standards, allowing those partners to participate and anticipate from our crypto resources in a secure and open way. And we have a partner portal, technology partner portal, allowing you to get better overview and more insights about the various kind of solutions we're going to offer, with some additional features like downloading white papers, brochures, etc. But I'm quite sure that Johan can give you additional information about that. Can give you additional insights about our partner portal. We also even offer a special bring your own key bundle, which consists of professional services, hardware, and the enablement for you to provide your key to the Microsoft Key Vault. Last but not least, our HSMs are also available as a service. So we are also offering here our HSMs as a service, so which gives you a cloud agnostic approach for your crypto devices and crypto material. And if you are interested in that, we can provide you additional information about that. So hope this gave you a good overview about the various kinds of features in combination with Microsoft Azure Key Vault. More than happy to answer your questions. You can ever reach out to me with my email address or my mobile number. And I'm, of course, here to answer additional questions. And I have to thank you very much now for your interest in our joint solution with Microsoft.
And yeah, thank you, Bernd. And before people run away, you know, I will take the opportunity to also share some more information in a few more minutes. So please do stay tuned. And thanks again, Bernd. A very, to the point presentation, short and sweet, but hitting all the bullets. And meanwhile, let me see if I can share my screen. That will help, of course. And yeah, let me see. Here we go. Yeah, it should be fine now. And no worries, it's just a few more slides, as said. Coming back to the whole wheel Bernd already showed a couple of times. There are very many interesting names. In total, I believe we have around 150 partnerships. And if you are a reseller or a client, so a company, making use of one of these technologies for the reasons you see in the outside of the purple circle. So, for example, if you're using Cryptometric for key management or IBM, or if you're using McAfee for security analytics, you know, please do get in touch with us, because via us we can improve the security of those solutions in place. And if you are a reseller, of course, you can bundle Ncipher into your existing business to have a healthy upsell, so to say. There are many Better Together bundles with our key partners together with Arrow, and I will share those with you on another slide in a few moments. Very important to state, and that's regardless if you are an end user or a reseller partner, you know, we are scaling up in the Belgium Luxembourg area now. You know, we have been active there for quite some time. We do have a couple of very interesting clients, of whom I also will share a few logos with you as well. But it's now to, you know, time to step on the train. It's leaving. You know, we have been investing heavily. Last year, we opened an office in the Netherlands to begin with. And out of the Netherlands, together with Arrow, who, as said before, are our local representative, we are supporting the Belgium and Luxembourg region. Also, if you don't have knowledge around the hardware security modules we produce, no worries, you just need to open the door and you get the technical and sales support from Ncipher. Also, you know, we are a company existing for over 20 years already, so it's not like a startup. So indeed, we have a partner portal, we have deal registrations, we have online trainings, on-site trainings, and so on, and so on. Most important, and that's something I, you know, shout out quite a few times regularly, it's all about protecting your master encryption keys via, you know, a hardware solution like ours. And if you don't do so well, then don't bother encrypting at all. And that always is a door opener, again, regardless if you are an end user or a reseller. As said, a couple of clients. So just to prove that we are not, you know, a startup, we are, it's very much proven technology. In many cases, these companies have bought our solutions to become compliant with several standards in an easy way, because if you buy an Ncipher HSM, you will get a lot of ticks in a lot of boxes from the auditors. So let's not go into those clients too much in detail. The circle, you remember, there are many logos of big, huge security vendors. We picked a couple of those where we have developed special bundles, or at least where we have special attention for in the Benelux, and these are on this slide. I won't go too much in depth, you know, let's keep it short and sweet as promised. The partner portal, interesting to say that we have special article numbers of which both resellers and end users can benefit, meaning that we simply have priced it in a very attractive way, so that you will bundle the solutions together. And we are doing that in conjunction, close conjunction with Arrow, of course. Here it says, you know, end of September, then they are still valid. Don't worry too much about who or what. It's all about, you know, getting in touch with us, because as said, we are scaling up. We are still looking for that one or two great partners who can help us in Belgium to grow the business. And I think the base is already there with, for example, the customer names I just showed. Well, deal registration, pretty straightforward. Not that big, it's just a few clicks away. As said again, let's work together. And let's not repeat myself. If you're interested, any questions in whatever kind of field, you know, feel free to contact Arrow, especially Bart de Grote or Joachim Qua Kapp, or just get in touch with myself, and then we take it from there. For now, thank you for your attention. I guess this was it. As said, I will be available by phone, by email, but also later on via the chat box today, and also the next coming 2 days. So thanks once more, merci, and hope to see you soon. Thanks.